I'm so excited that you're here.
Hello, I'm so excited to be here. Thank you for having me.
You know, when I was talking to Kat Kohler, who is producing your segment, we were just talking about, I was like, we have so much to talk about with Jake. Where do we even begin?
I love that.
It's true. I love that you took a road trip to go back to visit your family when the pandemic, you know, was at one of its highest points, and you like drove your car and you even felt compelled to like sleep in it. Tell me that story really quickly.
I did. I mean, just like everybody else, I've been missing my family, and it was a, you know, a huge break being out here in LA and them all being back in Ohio. So, yeah, in July, I drove back from here to Columbus. It took me over 30 hours over the period of 2 days. I slept in my car because I was so paranoid about seeing anybody or stopping. It was pretty wild, but I got it done.
And you stopped at like a rest stop or a parking lot, and you were really scared, and you looked around and you saw.
And I just saw so many other people doing it. I remember talking to my mom on the phone too, because, you know, we were debating whether or not I would stay in a hotel or, you know, try to stop at a friend's house. And we decided the safest thing, as crazy as it sounds, is to stop at a truck stop, which I did. And yeah, it was a little terrifying, especially after driving 17 hours. But
you saw families and other people doing it as well. That's why I really appreciated this story, because I know everybody's having to do things so differently right now.
Yes, yes. And it was wonderful to see my family.
Another story that I love is your horrifying auditions-like life. First of all, you were on iCarly and the Thundermans, and my daughters like love those shows. So I was so excited, because they're always on our TV kitchen, like, you know, our kitchen TV. And because that's where we eat at like this tiny, like 2 foot island. And we watch like the Thundermans. And I was like, oh my God, this is so exciting. But you came out, you did theater when you were young, you risked it all, you came to Los Angeles. You got these shows, but you had audition horror stories along the way. I have so many. Do you have one?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I feel like the most of my horror stories came from commercial auditions, which I was doing for, you know, the first 6 years that I was out here. And they were crazy because they were all so technical. And yet you were doing them in a room with, you know, the size of my closet, where you would have to be pretending like you're riding a bike. And then also Godzilla's chasing you, but you got to look at the camera and drink a Coca-Cola, like at a 72 degree angle. It's like insane. It's crazy what they ask you to do sometimes.
I went on an audition for that movie Cape Fear, and I was so like at a not great point in my career. I went in like on a Sunday morning with the like assistant, and I had to do like the finger in the mouth scene where I was like, and she was like, you can just stick your finger in your own mouth. And I was like, okay. Like, and it's true. They're like, stay in the chair, act like you're being chased by a monster, but like stay to the camera. And I also had an audition where a director never looked up from his papers and, you know, was just like, why are you here? And I was like, oh, wow.
It happens all the time where they're eating lunch and you're like,
yes,
trying to cry and pretend that, you know, your family is like, you know, leaving you forever. It's wild. It's wild.
It's so weird. Well, I'm so glad that you made it to where you made it. Grey's Anatomy airs Thursdays on ABC. Jake Borelli, everybody loves you. You're so awesome. Thank you for coming on our show.